Welcome back to the episode of Big Movie Mouth Off. We're here at the Fear Factory in Salt Lake City. It's a haunted house. They're our sponsors. You know, it's Halloween time.
Again.
Seems appropriate.
Every
October, it's always Halloween time. Kind of works out like
that. At least once a year.
I'm Jimmy Martin. You can find me on KUTV 2 News this morning every Saturday and Sunday, 7 to 8 a.m. You know, if you don't want to wake up with me, I always say DVR it and you can watch it, you know. When you wake up like at noon. I don't know what you guys do in bed that late, but it's fine. Or you can find me on KUTV.com. And, oh man, keep coming back.
I know.
Well, this is appropriate for you.
Oh, yes.
Introduce yourself.
A little too much in a way. I'm Brooks Bird with Blogcritics.org, back again for another horror movie, for better and worse. We'll tell you which.
Yeah, there you go. So you can find Big Movie Mouth Off on Xfinity Channel 6, also on their on-demand system. It's Utah On Demand. Movies and film folders right there. Movies young and old. If it's older, maybe it's on video on demand. You can order it on Xfinity. Or it's still in theaters like this one. It's Ouija! I mean Ouija.
In theaters now, but for one weekend.
What's going on? I just don't want to go out tonight.
You sure you don't want to come?
I'm good. Go have fun.
You ever feel like even after someone you love has died, there's still a way you can talk to them?
You want to talk to Debbie?
Yeah. This is where Debbie died.
I don't think this is a good idea.
As friends we've gathered, hearts are true. Spirits near, we call to you. If you can hear us, Debbie, I miss you.
Calm down. It's an old house.
This is a joke. Come on, you guys. Who's doing that?
Sarah, cut it out.
I'm not pushing it.
You just spelled hi, friend.
Hey, this is freaking me out. I'm done with this.
Of course, Ouija, I think everybody knows it's based on the Hasbro board game. Yes, I am calling it a board game. That's what I believe it is.
Well, because it's Hasbro, and that means people should know who the producer is.
That's right. It's Michael Bay! Hey! So, you know, nothing's better than when Hollywood has decided to start using board games. We had Battleship. I think there's always been a rumor for Monopoly.
So. It's been rumored for a while.
Yeah, so now we get...
Candyland's coming.
Yep. So now we get Ouija.
That's all we're calling it.
So it's the latest in, PG-13 horror films.
Which had gone away for a while.
And they really should have.
And should not come back.
So the story is that a group of friends have been playing with the Ouija board, led by Olivia Cooke. Most people know her from Bates Motel. She's the one with the oxygen mask. That's how we
say it. Oxygen tank that she carries everywhere.
That's right. So one of their friends gets possessed, because there's three rules when you're playing Ouija, apparently. It's never play by yourself, never play in a cemetery, and always say goodbye, which they should have said in the first 5 minutes of this film. So
should have been the opening scene.
Right? And so the friend doesn't follow the rules, gets possessed, and a spirit forces her to kill herself. All the friends are like, we don't know what happened. And so they were like, we can use the board.
Let's play Scooby-Doo.
Yeah. Well, they don't have a mystery machine. They just have a board, a Ouija board. So they're like, let's communicate with her and see if we can just find out what happened.
Find out. What killed her?
So what happens is, you know, they basically say, they communicate, they do contact somebody.
Oh, they make contact.
It's just not their friend. It's an evil spirit. And, you know, we always say wackiness ensues, but let's talk about what kind of wackiness does ensue.
There was wackiness that ensued, all right. It was not of the intentional kind at all.
Yeah. So we'll start off with this. Okay, so they start dying off one by one, all these friends, you know.
A little slowly.
Spoiler alert, don't really care.
People die.
And so he goes, like, my biggest issue with the first thing is, I mean, I got a lot of them. Trust me, we're going to be here for a minute. Sit tight. Is, you know, the first person gets killed, she's just brushing her teeth in her bathroom, gets possessed, like, floats up, and then bashes
her
skull on the thing.
It was, like, right out of Final Destination.
Yeah. But, at least with Final Destination, you're like, if, you know, if something falls at me, I can jump out of the way.
It always looks like an accident.
Yeah, whereas this one, the spirit can just take over you anywhere, anytime.
Even in an alley.
Yeah, and so, like, where's the thrill? Why doesn't he just kill everybody off so I can go home early?
There's no rhyme or reason.
So
no rules.
The other thing is, where are all the parents?
All of them went out of town.
Yeah, they all went out of town for work.
And they even showed them saying, we'll be out of town. Very convenient.
Hours after, like, their best friend just committed suicide. And then the mother of the one, of the, you know, thanks for watching our house where your best friend just committed suicide right there.
Right there hanging from the light fixture.
Have fun. You want to, oh, and you can sleep over too. Sleep over too. Oh, and here's a Ouija board, you know.
Oh, don't mind the Ouija board that showed back up on her bed after she burned it in the fireplace.
It makes absolutely no sense. Like, it blows my mind how stupid this movie really is.
Oh, man.
You know, and
it was a rough 89 minutes.
Yeah. And, you know, and that's, I almost was going to give it a point for that, but I'm not going to. Because here's the other thing, too. I mean, going back to PG-13 horror films, it is few and far between to get a PG-13 horror film to work. The only one that comes to my mind.
It's going to take a
lot. I say Drag Me to Hell.
Yeah.
That was a good PG-13 horror film.
That was one of the last really good ones.
Yeah. This one does everything it can to try to build tension in the dumbest of fashions. there's a scene where the kid's riding his bike.
And he gets off and starts to walk it for no reason whatsoever.
For no reason. Just goes, I'm going to hop off. And just start walking.
Because it was in the script.
And then, you know, something's
going. Told me to.
Yeah. And I'm going to walk really slowly through a dark tunnel. it's just... It is excruciatingly bad. I said,
so he can see the writing on the wall.
Yeah, I mean, you and I were laughing hysterically through this thing. You know, it's
especially towards the end. There's something that happens that was just a little too much. It was way too much. Of all the things that it had already done.
Yeah.
They do the dumbest thing possible.
It's it makes me laugh just because, you know, I walked out there like, what'd you think? And I was like, well, here you go. Here's the final score: laughs 50, scares 0. It's not even scary, you know? You're sitting there like...
It's hilariously bad.
When every film critic and a lot of the attendees are sitting there just laughing. You did it wrong. Styles White.
I don't think anyone actually even screamed, ever.
Yeah, I mean, this is, again, director Styles White. Never done a movie.
It's his first movie.
First movie. I hope it's his last. Well, I really do.
Considering the only other movies he's written was the Nicolas Cage classic Knowing. And 2005's Boogeyman.
Good Lord. Styles, seriously, man, go take a class. Learn how to do this right, because you're not doing it any justice of this art form.
I found something. I wanted to get this on camera. I found something in my house.
Weird things started happening as soon as I found the board.
Debbie found the board in her house. She woke something up.
Is somebody there?
This thing is haunting us.
Hello?
It's coming through all of us. So who's next?
How do we stop this? You have to break the connection, or it will keep coming for you.
We have to play the game again. One last time.
As friends we've gathered, hearts are true. Spirits near, we call to you.
Can you show us a sign?
Not even real, okay?
It only happens a few times, and I'm doing it today. 0 stars. Nothing. You wasted my life, and it really made me upset. And I will curse your name on my deathbed that I lost 89 minutes to Ouija.
The only thing I have left to say is it might make a fun drinking game for somebody. Somebody! So maybe for horror fans, you could get a half a star at most. But
you're giving a half?
I'll give it a half a star just because I was laughing so much that I enjoyed that aspect.
See,
but that wasn't the point.
And coming from you, because you love these things, and I usually, like, it takes me, I don't know, most of the things I just find stupid anyway, but sometimes it's more fun. Like, Annabelle was more fun.
Yeah, it had fun with itself. It knew what it was doing. It wasn't trying to be smart.
Excruciatingly bad. So 0 stars. A half a star, that fly is more entertaining than this movie. So that'll do it for this episode of Big Movie Mouth Off.
Get out of here along with the director.
That'll do it for this episode of Big Movie Mouth Off, and we'll catch you next time.